Now, right quick, guys, the counter arc is lateral movement opposite the direction of bend. It is similar to what you're saying, Rachel, about the drift. I call it a drifting circle where the hind is busier than the fore. That's one direction we can take this counter arc, but I prefer first to get it fully lateral.
Okay.
Okay, opposite the direction of bend. The third way you can take it is on a diagonal like a leg yield. Okay. I'm going to break that down for you, okay? So my intention changes from go position here, slightly ahead of the shoulder and in onto the shoulder. Now my new trajectory is through here, through the shoulders. I've got to help him get some weight off this forehand and move this shoulder across first. I can always catch the hind quarter up. That's the light end. That's easier. But I got to get this shoulder freed up. So for those of you who are still working on this or thinking this is down the road for you, you need the hind and fore turned loose to you independently first. That's just a prerequisite. So like Tiff, where you're working on stuff, your combination turn comes before the counter arc. Because you can yield the hind and fore independently before you hope to get the whole outfit moving. Right?
And this is for my big horse.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not for your little horse yet.
Oh no.
Give it a couple weeks though. You could get there easy.
Oh, in a couple of weeks. God, I was thinking like...
A couple of years.
No, I was thinking like more like I'd try and get the sass under control first.
Well, yes, but you can do this with your young horse, and in sooner the better.
Okay.
Yeah, just a little bit, but often, right? Not big sessions or anything, but yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
That 6-month-old foal had no trouble with it at all last winter, you know, just in little bite-sized pieces. Okay. When you're happy, at some point you're going to release that. The easiest way to release is simple stop. When you're done, or sending him back to the circle, because that's easier and more comfortable and more familiar, right? So you say, okay, good, now you're back into that circle, okay? Now here's the light bulb moment for some of us. When we've overdone and overcooked the hindquarter yield, having been taught that and drilled into us from day one, and we've, you know, screwed the front end down, and we've got to mechanize, we've got all these other negative aspects going on, okay? One other thing that we do with that is we kill forward motion. Okay, now with a real forward horse, you might not ever kill the forward motion and you don't even realize what you might be doing. We need to be able to ask for this horse to power up and give us his impulsion. We need to go somewhere with bend in the body, not just shut down forward motion through the hindquarter yield all the time. It'd be like us driving a Ferrari to the grocery store and back again once a week in a small town, never get over 25 miles an hour, right? That Ferrari can do that, no doubt. But you're probably a liability if you don't know how to actually drive that car at least 200 miles an hour and how it handles and what you could do with it. You might not like that. You might not like, you know, using the handbrake for skidding turns or peeling out at the stoplight. You might not like all that stuff, but honestly, you're probably a liability because you're going to be at a stoplight and get ready to go. You're going to peel out anyway on accident because you don't know how to drive the thing. It's the same thing here. Instead of killing forward by disengaging all the time, the counter arc engages the inside hind to provide forward momentum, thrust, power, and impulsion.
And where your canter comes from.
This is where everything should come from, yeah. Right? Because if they're moving with suppleness in the body, that inside hind is the thrusting hind limb. So now you're taking them to the gym, right? But it's got to have the quality forward impulsion in the first place, okay? So let me see where we're at with this. Whichever you think you can see what I'm doing and what he's doing the best.
This is Daniel. He's a good boy.
Okay, so we get a good walk going. We got a good go position.
He really
is. Then we get a little lateral movement back to the circle. We can work on a little trotting transition, see where he's at with something like that today with his foot. Good. Back to the circle. I don't need lots there. I'm just seeing where he's at with this. And this is hard work too, so it's not like I'm after quantity.
Do you see how he's going sideways?
So just a couple, three strides, and then I'm rewarding that quality effort, not the dying out of effort, but a quality there. And now, quit. You're good. Okay, did you see where my position was? I preserve my space. If I feel like he's a bit heavy here and we're not kind of getting enough, it's life. If I do this, boom, eliminate my space, run into a brick wall. Okay?